Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Bensalem High School, the ROTC, as we open the 2013 Bensalem Fall Festival Celebrate Community Pride. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Jenna Mann. She's going to sing the national anthem. Please give her a warm Bensalem welcome.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Welcome to our 22nd annual Pride Day Fall Festival. We welcome everybody today for a great, great day. The weather is perfect. Everyone on this stage, all these dignitaries, ordered the weather. So if you get to see them, thank them for the great day we're having today. I want to introduce everybody that's up here on the stage. We'll start with our council here in Bensalem, and certainly president of our council, Ed Kiselbeck. Ed, you want to say a couple words?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. And I do remember the Pride Day that we had, and it was wonderful. The mayor organized it, and now it developed into something that Dawn Davis has done a wonderful job working night and day putting this together. So let's hear a hand for Dawn Davis for doing what she's doing. Always in the background, but doing a great job. Well, you know, Bensalem is known as the volunteer city of the United States of America. We've been known, we have the title of America's best city. Also, we have been acknowledged from an organization as one of the 100 townships where you would want to raise your family. And that's not based on the people up here, even though we do a great job. It's based on you. It's based on the citizens of Bensalem, because we volunteer for everything, whether it's for the children, whether it's in sports activities, whether it's in the dance studios, whether it's volunteering to your neighbor next door, helping him cut his lawn and getting him to the store because he's an elderly person. But Bensalem, you make us proud. You're what it's about. And God bless you and thank you, and enjoy Pride Day. Thank you very, very much. And our council members are, we have Joe Polari, our vice president of council. We have our secretary, Tony Belfield. Step up, gentlemen. We have John Matthew, a council member. And we have Joe Knowles, also on council. And that's, we worked with the mayor. We try to make it the place that it is for you. And we thank you very much for everything you do for us. Thanks, guys. Mayor, thank you.
Thanks, Ed. And also up here, we have all of our county officers. First of all, we have Rob Lockery, who is our commissioner. Rob, you want to speak for the commissioners quickly?
Thank you for letting me be here.
Rob says, thanks for all of you coming today. Pat Bachtel, who is a prothonotary in the county. Duke Donnelly, who is our sheriff, so behave yourselves. You see the star. So we don't have him come after you today. And certainly an old Bensalem guy we have up here. Ray McHugh is the controller of the county, right? And last but not least is a guy that some of you might remember that was in Bensalem for a few years on council. Joe is now the recorder of deeds in the county, Joe Saffron.
Just real quick before the mayor makes the presentation, each year, we award two individuals what we call the Community Pride Award. And what that really is, it's to a volunteer who really doesn't look for the credit. We find them. Their acts of selflessness and their lack of wanting any recognition is why we recognize them. They are just individuals who are out there just helping people all over the community and beyond. And we're really happy this year with, I mean, we're happy every year with who we select, but this year is really special, and we're gonna do ladies before gentlemen. And Mayor, why don't you take it from there?
Thanks, Dawn. And obviously we have a very special lady today here. And where's Ruth at? Ruth Starring? Ruth, come on up. Honestly, for all the great, great work you have done, we salute you as a volunteer. And for I know you're older than 21, and so I can't say how many years. No, I'm not going to say that. I'm going to say how many years you've been a volunteer. I'll bet it's been three quarters of that. Long time. It's over 50 years, I can tell you that. So I present this to you, and this is from the township, myself and council, and we have somebody else that's going to come out here, Ed Devaney from the Eddington Fire Company, and all the gentlemen from there, and he's going to help present this to you and say a couple words.
Well, I have to agree with the mayor. The cakes and cookies are wonderful. Mrs. Starring has supported the Eddington Fire Company for over 40 years, her and her family. And today, we would like to present her with an honorary membership certificate from the Eddington Fire Company for her dedication and kindness to our organization. Thank you, Mayor. And Mrs. Starring, thank you very much.
Let's give her an unbelievable welcome here today for the great work that she's always done. God bless you, Ruth. God bless you and your family. You've done wonders.
I thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you.
God bless you. And we have another gentleman here. Don, would you come out? Don Anderson from Cornwells. That's where he lives, Tarsdale Manor, a great community. And I see all your families out here, and I know that they've been a big help. Now, I don't know how many of you ever come at Christmas time and come into the township, and there's a Santa Claus in there, and he represents Santa Claus right from the North Pole, and he is there every year, and last year especially. He was a little under the weather, but guess what? He showed up. He showed up and made a lot of kids so happy on that, and he's been doing that for a lot of years. I can't tell you how grateful we are what you do for the fire company, but how grateful in Bensalem of your volunteerism and what you've done for so many years. And how many years you've been a fireman? 49 years as a fireman, putting out your fires out there in Bensalem. Again, Don, from myself and council, how grateful we are for all of the work you do. And you're going to have to say a few words.
I just want to say thank you very much for the honor. And like Joe said, without my family, I couldn't do it. So thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Have a great, great, great day here. The weather's perfect. Enjoy.
Thank you. welcome to the 2013 Fall Festival Canine Demonstration. Heading the unit, Sergeant Dave Richardson and his canine partner, Prince. Corporal James Earl McGinney and his canine partner, Axel. Officer Mike Shum and his canine partner, Argo. And Officer Matt Toby and his canine partner, Ozzy. What you're going to see in the first demonstration is what's called a passive indication for explosives. Now this is what's called a luggage passive indication. As you saw, he sat down, Prince, which is an indication that he found an explosive. Our next demonstration, Officer Matt Toby and his canine Ozzy, he's going to be conducting a narcotic search of a vehicle and luggage. Indication? He'll start scratching, ladies and gentlemen, and that's what he did. Now he's going to see if there's luggage, see if he can find some drugs in the luggage. Oh, and there it is, folks. Found the drugs. Good job, Ozzy. Our next demonstration is going to be by Corporal McGinney with his canine partner, Axel. And he's going to demonstrate obedience. Now our next demonstration is going to be performed by Officer Toby, and this is what's called the agility. You heard Corporal McGinney give his verbal commands, that's the warning, and that dog leaped in that car. Now he's going to put him on the car and he's going to pat him down. You've probably seen that in cops at one point or another. Good boy. Good boy. Again, imagine that. 300 to 600 pounds per square inch of force. Don't resist. Stop resisting. Stop resisting. Dinner. See that sleeve, folks, on his arm? As thick as that sleeve is, Corporal McGinney feels that. He feels the pressure on his arm. All right, stand by, Vox. We got a pursuit. He's not stopping. He's taking off. He's still running. Oh, he stopped. He's getting out of the car. Shots fired, folks. Shots fired. Apprehended. In custody.
Original name of the group was Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes, but because of the fact that our father, our mentor, Mr. Harold Melvin, has passed away in 1997, we have become Harold Melvin's Blue Notes.
Y'all are out here. Sometimes, come on,
come along and sing along. Sing along with the sing along. Your turn.
If you don't know it by now, you will never, never, never know me. Ooh.
All the things that we've been through, you should understand. Like I understand you.
Now baby,
I know the
difference. Listen to me, baby.
Between right and wrong. Now I ain't gonna do nothing to upset our happy home.
Oh,
oh, I don't get so excited.
Oh,
when I come home a little late at night. Cause we all to act like children. We are the boss and fun, yeah, yeah.
As a matter of fact, wouldn't everybody like to know the name of each individual member of the group? Wouldn't that be nice, y'all? So maybe introduce ourselves to y'all? All right, I'm Rufus Thorne, first tenor.
Donnell Big Daddy Gillespie, lead singer. Tony Brooks, just a member.
John the Hammer Morris, second tenor.
See if y'all remember this. Hey, hey, hey. Go, go, goodbye. Hey, hey. Down hard and confused because lately you've been starting to lose. This is not everything you might try to do. Bad luck spell has got a hold on you. Losing your money, about to lose your home. And lost a woman and everything you own. Thought that was plain mistakes, the chances go around. If you want to know the truth about a tag, what's pulling you down?
Come on, yo.
You got
bad luck.
Yes, sir. That's what you got.
Bad luck. That's what you got.
You got
bad luck,
got
bad luck,
yeah.
Oh, my favorite song is Wake Up Everybody. And
my favorite song would probably be The Love I Lost. I love the dance routine, the choreography we do.
Hey, I'm back here in the corner. I have no favorite song. They all are my favorite song. I love them.
My favorite song is like If You Don't Know Me By Now and Wake Up and The Love I Lost, all of them, like I said before, yes.
Wake up everybody, no more sleeping in bed, no more backwards thinking, time for thinking again.
You know,
the world has changed so very much from what it used to be.
You know,
there's so much hatred, war and poverty. Oh, 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 oh. All the teachers come to teach a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say. They're the ones who's coming up, and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children, teach them the very best you can.
Teach them the very best you can.
The world
won't get
no
better.
No, no. If we just let it be.
Na, 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 na.
The world won't get no better. We gotta change it.
I thought, look, it's a very nice place. It's the first time I've been here. It's like one of the grandest outdoor events I've ever been. We're pleased to be here, and it's a nice place for us to turn out, cause we're gonna turn this place out. Yeah, and so all in Bensalem that hears about it, you missed it. This is something you want to see.
Everybody, come on and sing. You see.
The love I lost was a sweet love.
Yes, it was.
The love I lost was complete love.
Yes, it was. Remember planning, building my whole world around it. I can remember hoping that you and I could make it all through. Well, but something went wrong. What happened, y'all?
We loved each other, we just couldn't get along.
That's right. Take a good look at me, I'm a misery. Can't you see?
Was a sweet love.
Yes, it was.
The love I lost was complete love.
Yes, it was.
The love I lost.
right here. Make some noise. Woo!
Hi, this is Earl Young, the Trammps, and we are here to burn this mother down.
We'd like to say good evening to everybody out there. Thank you so much for giving us a warm welcome in your town. We love it here because this is the party house tonight, right? Well, let's do it. If you know this song, sing along with us.
Hold back the night, turn on the lights, I wanna dream.
They know this one.
Dream about your baby. Hold back the night, turn on the lights, I wanna dream.
Took the sun right out of my sky, yes you did. Wondered why you went away and never told me why. When the sun goes down and the moon is asleep, I'm scared to death because your face
is bleeding. Hold back the night, turn on the lights, don't wanna dream. Dream about your baby. Hold back the night, turn. About you, baby.
Yes, I formed the Trammps back in 1972. The first recording was Zing Winter Strings in My Heart. And this was taken from, I don't remember a song by Judy Garland called Zing Winter Strings in My Heart. It was Dear When You Smile at Me, I Heard a Melody. And that was our first hit.
Sing with the strings of my heart.
I'm getting ready to go on stage now, and I have to say one thing. This is one of the best places I've ever worked, because everything here is so comfortable. We have a concrete stage, and we dance a lot, so we can do all the disco dances. The atmosphere is good. The people here are ready to party. They are ready to jump up and down and shout and dance their hands off. And they gave us such a warm welcome as we approached here. And that means a lot, you know, when you go somewhere and people give you such a warm welcome. So we hope that we can really come back here again.
You know that I was making love. I remember on the 13th of July, the only light was a light up in the sky. New York had a blackout for 25 hours or more, and nobody really knows the reason why. Ooh, somebody pulled the plug out of the socket. It's safe to say I went to the door to lock it. So I took my little body,
took her body,
and led her to her land.
Where were you?
Where were you when the lights went out in New York City? All over the town. Where were you when the lights went out in New York City? Don't you know that I was making love?
Our biggest hit was Disco Inferno. And a lot of people always ask us, where did the song come from? But the song came from the motion picture, The Towel Inferno. If you remember The Towel Inferno, they were partying up on the roof and this fire broke out. So we had an idea about party on the roof. And that's how the song got together. Like when they say, burn, baby, burn. And the song was so big, they put it in the motion picture Saturday Night Fever, which sold over 25 million copies. And wherever the motion picture Saturday Night Fever went, we went along with it. So we've been all over the world. And at the age now of 73, I'm still going all over the world again. And I'm not going to quit. And I'm just so glad now to be home in my hometown here, Philadelphia.
To the rhythm with a heart and soul. Saturday night,
I'm home, I'm out of my work clothes. When I'm out on the street, oh, 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 I walk the way I wanna walk. When I'm out on the street, oh, 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 I talk the way I wanna talk. When I'm out on the street, when I'm out on the street, let's go!
Somebody, somebody, somebody.
crowd shovels in. There's an old man sitting next to me, making love to his tonic and gin. He says, son, can you play me Memory? I'm not really sure how it goes, but it sounded and sweet, and I knew it complete. And I wore a younger man's clothes. Oh, na 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 na.
Gonna hurt someone before the night is through. Somebody's gonna come undone. There's nothing we can do. Everybody wants to touch somebody.